We were doing How He Loves. I was looking up here at a lot of just boys and girls, which I knew most of. The Spirit of God just kind of over me. I thought, you know, as much as all of you moms and dads of all these boys and girls, God loves us so much, it makes our love for them look like hatred. I began to just sit over there, think about that, and then during that other song, when we began to, Max began to sing that part, shout out to the masses, and I thought, these boys and girls all have the opportunity to grow up in a setting where from a young age they're hearing the gospel. Listen, the masses are not having that experience. There are boys and girls all around the globe that will be born, live their life, and die, and never hear the name of Jesus. As I thought about that, a church, that's why we can never back down. That's why we can never slow down. That's why we can never turn around. We've got to keep marching forward with the gospel of Jesus Christ, because the masses in the world need to hear. Listen, there are boys and girls all around the world that Jesus loves just as much as these boys and girls, that Jesus died for just as much as these boys and girls. That if the church doesn't get serious about the call to carry the gospel of the nations, will never hear His name. Listen, He loves us. But He loves them too. And we can never bask in the greatness of His love for us without being moved with compassion for the masses. I don't really know what to do, but God's just... Listen, He's going to hold my heart tonight. Church, we must remain committed to what really matters. Let's just pray. Father, God, thank You that these boys and girls, Lord, have the opportunity to grow up and to hear Your glorious gospel. Lord, they have the opportunity to grow up and be taught what it means to worship the one true God. Lord, they get to grow up being taught the Word of God. But God, as we sit here tonight, Lord, almost one third of our world's population sits in total darkness with no access to the gospel. No missionary, no church, no gospel tract, no Bible in their language, nothing. Millions upon millions upon millions upon millions. Boys and girls all around the world. That unless we begin to penetrate the darkness and the lostness, we'll never hear the nature. Lord, may the truth that we sang as boys and girls, that Jesus loves the little children of the world, all the children of the world, red, yellow, brown, black, and white, they are precious in Your sight. God, may that truth be burned into our hearts afresh and anew tonight. God, may we stay committed to the task before us. not for us, but for those who have never heard of Him. God, everything you do here through this body, you do for the purpose of the masses. Lord, let us never forget that. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. You have your Bibles tonight. I want you to turn to the book of 1 Thessalonians. I want to share with you very briefly one verse of Scripture and a few truths from that verse. Then we're going to give opportunity for people to respond to the Lord Jesus tonight. After we do that, we're then going to have time of serving the Lord's Supper. But I want to just share with you, Thursday is Thanksgiving, which for most of us means three things. Food, family, and football, right? I was thinking earlier this week, I would assume that 99.999999999% of people in the world, or at least that percentage of people in America, Thursday will spend more time preparing food, eating food, watching football, and hanging out with family, they'll spend actually giving thanks. The Bible says a lot about giving thanks. I want to just share with you 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 18. The Apostle Paul says, in everything, give thanks. For this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus. In everything, give thanks. Now, I want to point out, Paul didn't say for everything, give thanks. There's a big difference. He didn't say to give thanks for everything. But he did say to give thanks in everything. See, for you and I as the child of God, people talk about Thanksgiving and they always ask the question, is it a religious holiday or a secular holiday? Listen, if you think as Christians we have one day a year we're supposed to give thanks, you've sorely misunderstood the New Testament. Listen, for you and I as believers, every day is a day of Thanksgiving. Every day is a day of giving thanks. And I believe in this verse that we've read, I believe there are three very clear truths about why you and I can give thanks in everything. And I want to share these with you. We're going to be done. This will be probably the shortest message I've ever preached at Highland Park Baptist Church. You don't get that often, so you better enjoy it, all right? Number one, we can give thanks in everything because we have a God who is in complete control. We have a God who is in complete control. Again, there in that verse 18, he said, in everything give thanks, for this is God's will. God's will. We have a sovereign God. Now, when you think about the will of God, I think it's best to think about the will of God in two basic parameters. There is the perfect will of God, and I believe there has been a permissive will of God. And to be honest, you and I right now, we're dwelling in the permissive will of God. The perfect will of God was violated in the Garden of Eden when Adam and Eve sinned against the Holy God, when they violated God's law and they decided to go back to their own sinful flesh and their own sinful indulgences. And at that very moment, to some degree, the perfect will of God was violated. But I want you to know, God has a will, and the will of God will never be thwarted. The will of God will never be overturned. God's will is going to be accomplished. You mark it down, the will of God will be accomplished. And you and I can give thanks because we have a God who is in control. Listen, I don't know what might happen in your life this week. I don't know what might happen in your life tomorrow or Tuesday or Wednesday or next month or next year. I don't know what 2013 holds for us. And I'll be honest, this week's been a rough week at my household. It has. Because Hostess announced they were closing all the bakeries. children that will grow up and never know what it is to eat a Twinkie. Yellow sponge cake, cream in the middle. Only God knows how they get the cream in the middle of the yellow sponge cake. But they're going to grow up never knowing what it is to eat a Twinkie. I'm telling you, I've sat in depression all day when they announced. Trying to figure out if you can go buy them and freeze them. I don't know how long you can keep them in the freezer. But I read a statement yesterday on Twitter, and somebody said, you know, I keep seeing all these people who said, man, I'm going to sure miss a Twinkie. I haven't had one in so long. And I thought about, you know, that's why they're going out of business, right? Listen, there is nothing in your life that catches God off guard. He is in complete control. God's not sitting on his throne in heaven worried about what's going on. Listen, this morning we prayed over the situation in the Middle East, and we prayed for the Palestinians, and we prayed for the Jews, and we prayed for their leaders, and I'll encourage you to continue to do that. And I don't know what's the outcome that is, but listen to me. God does. He's not in heaven wringing his hands, wondering and whether or not there's going to be nuclear warfare. He's not up there wringing his hands, wondering whether or not the Palestinians or the Jews are ever going to get along. God is in complete control. He is on the throne of the universe tonight. He is in control, and you and I can give thanks because we have a God who's in control. We might not understand everything that happens in our life, but listen, in everything, you can trust Him. You can trust Him. Number two, we can give thanks in everything because God's will for His children is to bless and to benefit them. We can give thanks in everything because God's will for His children is to bless and to benefit them. Again, in our verse 18, he said, in everything give thanks, but this is God's will. Here it is, for you. So we say all the time, God has a plan and a purpose for your life, but I want you to know He really does. God has a plan for you. God loves you. We sang a moment ago about how wonderful and how much this God loves us. And I want you to know, He really does. He really loves you. He loves you. He loves you. And it is His will in the lives of His children to bless and to benefit them. That's His desire. Remember Jesus one day was talking and He said, you know, how many of you as fathers give good gifts to your children? And He said, you being wicked, how much more do you think your heavenly Father desires to do good things for those who love Him? Listen, Jesus loves you. Now, we've allowed the faith movement, the name it and claim it, blab it and grab it movement to rob a lot of the truths out of the Word of God. I want you to know the teaching of the Word of God is that God wants to do things in your life to bless and to benefit you. Now, I want to categorize that a little. Because what God wants to do sometimes to bless and benefit you is not necessarily what you think will bless and benefit you. See, some of you think you know what will bless and benefit you, but in reality, if you got what you thought would bless and benefit you, what it would actually do is it would actually hurt and hinder you. And so we have to trust this God who's in control, that He knows what He's doing in bringing things into our life to bless us and to benefit us. In Jeremiah chapter 29, 11, God said, I know the plans I have for you. There's that phrase again, declares the Lord. Plans for welfare and not for calamity, to give you a future and a hope. God is at work in everything to bless you. Now sometimes that blessing comes wrapped in a nice pretty bow. That's exactly what we would like it to look like. Sometimes blessing actually comes in the form of discipline. Right? I mean, parents, let's get honest. Now, we got a lot of kids in here, and I'm going to amaze you right here, kids. This is going to stun you. But as parents, we don't discipline because we really enjoy doing it. I know some of you kids, you think the reason mom and dad have timeouts and the reason mom and dad spank and the reason mom and dad ground is because we just sit around and dream up ways to make your life miserable, but we really don't. We understand that through discipline, we're positioning you to be in a place to experience blessing and for your benefit. God does the same thing with His children. See, sometimes the greatest means of blessing and benefit in your life is through discipline. Sometimes the greatest means of blessing and benefit in your life is through difficulty. But you can rest assured that in everything, God is at work for you. And then number three, we can give thanks in everything because in Christ, we have all that we need. And in verse 18, Paul said, "In everything, give thanks, for this is God's will for you in Christ Jesus." Listen, in Jesus, you've got everything you need. For those of you that are in Christ tonight, listen, in Christ, you've got forgiveness of sin. Tonight, for those of you that are in Christ you have the removal of all condemnation. Tonight, in Christ, you have the promise of eternal life in heaven. Tonight, in Christ, you have justification and sanctification and one day the promise of glorification. Tonight, in Christ, you have joy, you have peace, you have contentment, you have meaning, you have purpose, you have fulfillment, you have peace. Listen, in Christ tonight, you've got everything you need. And just in case you think in your mind that there's something you might need that the Word of God doesn't cover, in Philippians chapter 4, verse 19, Paul said, "And my God will supply all your needs according to His riches in glory in Christ Jesus." Our problem is, we don't believe that. You don't know why we cry and grumble and complain? Because we don't believe that our God will supply all of our needs according to His riches in Christ Jesus. Some of you right now sitting in this room worried to death about the economy, worried about your own personal finances, worried what 2013 is going to bring. Worried, well, I'm not sure you're going to be able to provide Christmas for your children this year. Just worry. You don't know why you're worried. Because you don't believe what the Word of God says. Paul said, "My God shall supply all my need according to His riches." And hear me real quick. His riches are better than anybody else's riches. You talk about the greatest welfare system in the universe, it's God's. He gives and gives and gives and gives, and we just get. My God shall supply all your need. He didn't say He shall supply all your want. Because once again, He's in control. Because a lot of times what we want, if we got it, it mess us up. It mess us up some awful. I mean, let's be honest. You think about some of those things deep down in your heart you'd really like to have. Listen, if you got it, it mess you up. It caused problems in your family. It caused problems in your work. It caused problems in your other relationship. It mess everything up. But God's in control. God wants to benefit and bless your life. And God has the means of meeting every need of your life and has promised to do so. So in that, you and I can sit back as believers, as children of God, and say, "Lord Jesus, thank you." We can give thanks. Father, Lord Jesus, thank you. God, thank you that you love us so. God, you love us more than we could ever imagine. God, you love us more than we can comprehend. God, you love us. God, you desire for us to be in relationship with you. God, you want to do things in our lives and through our lives, Lord, for your glory, but God, also for our good and our benefit. Thank you for that. Lord, if anybody can give thanks, it's those of us that have been washed in the blood, had our sins forgiven, living in a relationship. God, I pray for people in this room tonight that might not have ever trusted you as their Lord and Savior. God, I pray tonight, Lord, just as Zach did a few weeks ago, Lord, just as two young men did earlier this week and as two young men did this morning in Sunday school, I pray they'd come and say, I need Jesus in my life. Repent of sins and place their faith in you as the Lord and Master, entering into a covenant relationship with you that forever changes their life. Lord, I pray they'd come. God, maybe there's some that need to come tonight with this church family. Maybe there's some that just need to come and get in this altar and thank you. Maybe they're in their seats and just need to get honest before you.